But Joachim, let's come to you.
Yeah.
Right. Plenty of that to talk about.
Sure, sure.
And let me give you the good news. Dumnode is staying here because he has developed a love for that.
Sure. And he asked me one question, why was
and it was he wants to say that that's what
he asked me.
He wants to say that I had a question.
He asked me
because he just, I think I whispered into his ear. Why was that because I saw when I was at the NYC camp, I saw some participant of that game playing Scrabble, playing chess. But nobody was doing that. So I was asking him, why is that not at the Dunk Games?
We tried to talk to the organizers, and then they said there was this selection that went on, and the various states selected the games
that they
wanted to participate in.
And you didn't play the politics well. Just like you're not playing the politics well, you're not
supposed to play. There should be no politics in some of these things.
You
are creating opportunities for the youth. So, as far as I'm concerned,
I
think some of these policies we implement are discriminatory. We should open up the games. Bring in all the games, bring in all the sports, because you don't know the one that the children will pick and the children will excel in. First of all, you should also understand that a time when we have unemployment bringing down the neck of all the youths in this, most of the youths in this country, we need to create other ways through which we will empower the youths of this country. And that is why I keep on insisting that when you have developmental programs, you cannot select which ones you will pass, which ones you will feature, and which ones you will take out.
I agree with you.
But open it up to everybody.
Let everybody be part of it. Let every sport be given equal opportunity because we don't know which one will turn that child into the superstar.
When I was young, I played football. I played
all the sports.
All the board, most of the games.
But today, not the board games. But in,
because
in
it's exciting. And it helps me use my brain. And it excites me. For some other people, they want the physical nature in other sports.
I agree with you.
It's just a plan. That's the advice.
Spot on. Joachim is spot on. Let's encourage all the sports. You don't know which one will turn that child into a superstar.
That's the important
thing. Into a field tailor,
yes.
For example, where he makes all the money.
Let's talk that now.
Let's start from Nigeria. You talked about the Nigerian police, also trying to create opportunities for kids to learn that and for that to go as a sport in Nigeria.
Yes, the Nigerian police is planning a police tournament. And it's very nice that they've taken that. They've chosen that, the Nigerian Police Dart Association. They're the one putting this tournament together for the police officers. And it's very, very important for me, and it's very, very interesting. Because, you know, that is a precision sport. There are three qualities you must have when you are
going to do that. And that's what you expect from a military, military mind.
It has this military disposition. First, you need good eyes. You need good eyes.
To spot where the enemies are.
You need good brains. And something that is very, very important, especially for those that shoot, you need what? Steady hands. During the Bile games, that they held in Europa, they achieved only 180. Even though we know Europe, they get 180 as if it's so easy to get. But one person achieved 180. And I asked, who is this person? I found out that it was a policeman. He was a police boy. He was a police, whether a police recruiter, a police officer, whether it was from the police. It pointed to one fact that he was using that to train how steady his hand could be, and that was why he could get 180 easily. So we always recommend any day that that should be introduced to the forces, because we need sharpshooters.
I agree with you. But let's go abroad. Talking about sharpshooters and talking about steady hands and winning plenty of money, this Dutchman. Not Michael Van Gerwen this time.
Yes.
Raymond Van Barneveld has shown Composure, steadiness, steady hands, good brains, according to Joachim.
Yes.
And is earning for himself £150,000 from the Premier Darts League.
Yes.
Joachim, very quickly, tell us about this.
For me, it's very sweet. Because for so long here, first of all, in his quarterfinal game, he played against Phil the Power Taylor. He has somehow, they say, he has, let me not talk, there are certain words we can use. But he has always been the underdog whenever he played Phil Taylor, especially in the Premier League. He has never beaten Phil Taylor in the Premier League. That semi-final match was fantastic because at the beginning of the match, Phil Taylor went 4-1 up. Everybody thought it was over for Raymond Van Barneveld. From nowhere, we don't know where he drew strength from. I call him the humble giant. He's there taking it one step at a time. And before we understood what was happening, he took Phil Taylor to the cleaner. Very sweet. And he now went to meet, I call him Alvin the Terrible. The man that, the boy that has no respect for anybody. That's MVG. MVG, that's why in the finals we had, we call it the Battle of the Dutch Masters. And it shows the quality of that in Netherlands is growing, growing effectively. Because we have two Dutch players.
In the final.
In the final.
Everybody would have expected that with Michael van Gerwen.
That was it.
What happened to him? Was it the case of underrating his opponent or something?
I think he was a shadow of himself, first of all. And he thought, for as far as he was concerned, he was going to beat
Van Beneden.
Especially the first throw in that match, Michael van Gerwen gave 180, first throw. But Van Beneden taught him a lesson that it is good to be humble. It's good to be steady
and not take
things for granted. It's good not to take things for granted. And he punished Van Gerwen for every mistake that Van Gerwen did. He took advantage of this and whipped him like a small boy.
You talked about small boys now. There's a small boy that is also winning good money.
Yes.
And no. showing that he has the heart of a man.
Of a man.
Talk to us about this PDC Unicorn Championship.
Yes, the youth
World Youth Tournament.
Yes, the youth are not left out in all of this, because you see, we have the PDC World Youth Program that is for players from the age of 15 to 21. And you can see that yesterday they crowned a new World Youth Champion, and that's Keegan Brown. He's been doing so well in the PDC, and he's playing that. But yesterday he won himself £10,000. That's about 2.6 million naira. I'm sure he's smiling. Look at the smile he has in his face there, which is so sweet. But Keegan, if you know his achievement when it comes to that, in the UK Opens, he qualified among the top 96 for 2013 and 2014. In the PDC World Youth Tour in England, he won it in 2012. That tells you that is, and this young boy has beaten Fitelo twice. Even though he looks young, and he's just 21 years.
The power twice,
and he's just 21 years.
Let me ask you.
He's just 21 years.
African country took part in this.
South Africa.
Because I know South Africa. I know in your preview to this.
Yes. South Africa.
What was South Africa's position?
South Africa did not. They featured two players, but the two players dropped out long. And didn't get to the finals. They dropped out in the preliminary stage because they are still introducing it to the youth in South Africa. But in Nigeria, the question still remains, what are we doing concerning the youth? It is important. That is why we are advocating that they should open it up. You should not discriminate against certain sports. Every sport should be given an opportunity so that when we have a World Youth Championship like this, we should have young players, age 15 to 20 from Nigeria, featuring there, and they can work away with 2.7 million.
That's why we have you here. We have to close the show now. But the Sports Tonight is not over yet. Our last shot on Sports Tonight for this week is an interesting one. It's a tribute to a fallen hero. Remember, a couple of weeks ago, we brought you the story of Albert Onyewuna, a former Nigerian international who played in the 60s and was the captain of the Nigerian national team at that time. Yeah, he died in Lagos, and people did not really read too much about it or see too much about it as well. But the Nigerian Football Federation and the Anambra State Government have promised that Albert Onyewuna will get befitting burial. And we're closing the show tonight by bringing you the reaction of the wife, the widow of Albert Onyewuna. That's Teresa, his daughter, Ngozi. The Commissioner for Sports in Anambra State, Tony Nacheta, who is also a former board member of the Nigerian Football Association at that time, and of course the Vice President of the Nigerian Football Federation, Mike Ume, also had a few things to say about it. We'll leave you with that as our parting shot on Sports Tonight this Friday, and we tell you we'll be back on Monday. Enjoy your weekend, and be good to yourself. Bye-bye now.
He was not only a husband to me, a father, a brother, great companion, and my best friend. I'm going to miss him. Since he left me, I've not been myself.
Well, you feel sad. And this is where I give glory to God that he was close to God, and he got to the ripe age of more than 70 before he died.
We have to give enough time for the football fraternity to go to Brazil
and come back.
For as an example of what to wait for. And then put this in touch to a number of arrangements. All right? And enable the media to prepare because to bury him, we need to let the media know, Nigerians know, many are forgotten who he was and what he did for Nigeria. At the point, it was the only source of happiness for Nigeria. Because by the time he did finish his dribbles, Nigerians on radio will be screaming. And they play music singing his name for the next 1 week, 1 month. Today, Onyango is the equivalent, those is the equivalent of whether you have with P squares, this and that, flavor, all of them together. Because he was such a fantastic footballer.